Welcome. In this video, I'm going to show you how to create single and multi-item forms. We're going to do two forms. So let's get started here. We've got our table agents and our table properties. If you haven't had a chance to look at the data that's in these tables, please take a moment to open them up and look inside at the data. And then when you're done, close all of the sheets. We're going to go under the Create tab, and the first thing we're going to use is the Form Wizard to create a wizard form. We're going to create a form from the Table Agents. So clicking on Form Wizard and selecting Table Agents, and then using the double chevrons to pull in all of the fields. Clicking Next, we're going to leave it in. We're going to call this Form, FRM, Agent. Click Finish. Now we'll just update the heading here. And so to do that, we need to switch from Form View, which is what we can see here, to Layout View. So right-clicking to go into Layout View, and then double-clicking on the title. Let's call this Agents. And when I minimize the height of that field, the whole header minimizes as well. The options at the bottom, we can scroll through all of the different agents. And then using the arrow with the little star next to it, we can create a new record. So let's go ahead and do that. Enter your first name and last name. Oh, first to be able to do that, we need to switch back into Form View. So Layout and Design View are going to let you modify the look of the form, but they won't let you enter any data. So you do need to be in Form View to do that. So now back in Form View, add your name as the seventh agent. And let's save this. Now we're going to click on Table Properties if it's not selected already. And we're going to create a form that's a multi-item form from this table. So let's go under Create. We will go under More Forms and select the multiple items. This is going to show lots of records at once, so it'll allow us to modify multiple records in the same form. So here we have it, just right away, it creates that for us. Because we selected Table Properties, it is creating a form based off of that, and we are currently in Layout View. Let's go ahead and update the title to Property Listings. And we can just delete this little icon here. So make sure you save this as Form Properties.